Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome to the series PIB 24/7. I'm your mentor Manish Mishra and in this session we will discuss 5 questions from the PIB news. This series PIB 24/7 is beneficial for various government exams like UPSC, State PSC, RBI, etc. So let's begin with the session guys. So in today's session we will discuss first about Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana. Then about Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, okay? Pradhan Mantri JJBY and PMSBY, we will discuss these two schemes and then we will move on to the changes, जो भी इसके अंदर नए changes आए हैं, जो भी नए announcement हुए हैं, that we will do through some questions, okay? So Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, it is a social security scheme. This was launched in 2015 under unorganized workers. Social Security Act of 2008 by Ministry of Finance. Ministry of Finance is headed by Nirmala Sitharaman. The objective of this scheme is to provide insurance to unorganized workers, especially those who are poor and underprivileged. And it is available to all the people in the age group of 18 to 50 years. And it provides a life cover of rupees 2 lakh for 1 year period stretching from 1st June to 31st May. A premium of rupees 330 per annum per member is given and it is renewable every year. It is a pure term insurance policy which covers only mortality with no investment component. Isme koi bhi investment component nahi hai and it offers coverage for death due to any reason. Kisi bhi karan se agar mrityu hoti hai to ye usko cover karta hai. And it is administered through both public and private sector insurance companies in tie-up with scheduled commercial banks, regional rural banks and cooperative banks. Alright. Now let us discuss about Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. So guys, PM Suraksha Bima Yojana, it is also a social security scheme for unorganized workers and this was also launched in 2015 under Unorganized Workers Social Security Act of 2008 by Ministry of Finance. It is an accident insurance scheme. Okay. It is an accident insurance scheme. And it offers a 1 year accidental death and disability cover which can be renewed annually. And this scheme is not a mediclaim. That is, there is no provision for reimbursement of hospitalization expenses following accident resulting in death or disability. Matlab ki agar accident ke baad death ya disability ho jati hai, to isme hospitalization expenses ka koi, for hospitalization expenses ki payment ka koi provision nahi hai, okay? And the scheme, this scheme is available to the people in the age group of 18 to 70 years and this cover is for a for 1 year period starting from 1st June to 31st May of subsequent year and the premium of rupees 12 per annum per subscriber has been taken from the applicant, okay? So guys, there are lot of differences between PMJJBY and PMSBY. Like PMSBY, it is purely an accidental insurance scheme, while PMJJY covers life and it covers death due to any reason. And also the premium here is rupees 12, while in PMJJBY it is rupees 330. And also there is a difference of age limit. In PMJJBY it is 18 to 50, while in SBY it is 18 to 70. Okay, and there is also difference of cover. The risk coverage available in PMSBY is rupees 2 lakh for accidental death and permanent total disability, while rupees 1 lakh for permanent partial disability. And what is this permanent total disability and permanent partial disability? So permanent total disability, it is defined as total and irrecoverable loss of both eyes or loss of use of both hands or feet or loss of an eyesight and loss of use of a hand or a foot. Okay. And permanent partial disability, it is defined as total and irrecoverable loss of an eyesight or loss of use of a hand or a foot. This is permanent partial disability. And this scheme is also administered through both public and private sector insurance companies in tie-up with scheduled commercial banks, regional rural banks and cooperative banks. Okay. So this was all about the schemes PMJJBY and PMSBY. Now let us move on to the questions. So for questions, a paragraph is given. You have to study the paragraph and then answer the given questions. Okay. In order to provide social security benefits to the workers in the unorganized sector, the government has enacted the DASH. This act stipulates formulation of suitable welfare schemes for unorganized workers on matters relating to life and disability cover, health and maternity benefits, old age protection, and any other benefit as may be determined by the central government. Life and disability cover is provided through Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana and Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana to the unorganized workers depending upon their eligibility. Ministry of Finance launched the scheme, and since June 2017, Ministry of Labour and Employment has been implementing the converged PMJJBY and PMSBY to provide life and disability coverage to the unorganized workers depending upon their eligibility. Okay guys, so let's move on to the first question. What will fill the gap? A, in the passage. So what was the gap? In order to provide social security benefits to the workers in the unorganized sector, the government has enacted the Unorganized Workers Social Security Act of 2008. Both the schemes PMJJBY and PMSBY were launched under this act, Unorganized Workers Social Security Act of 2008 by Ministry of Finance. Okay. Now next question is, since 2017 these schemes are called as Converged PMJJY and PMSBY. Why? So let us discuss about this. So guys, there was a scheme which is known as Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana. This scheme was launched in 2013. This scheme has been transferred to Ministry of Labour and Employment from Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance, and has been merged under PMJJBY, PMJJBY and Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana. Iske andar in Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana ko in dono schemes ke andar converge kar diya gaya. And existing beneficiaries of Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana were divided into two groups. First group from 18 to 50 and second group from 51 to 59. Why up to 59 only? Because under Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana the age limit was 18 to 59 years. So isme do groups banaye gaye. Ek wo jo 18 years se 50 years ke the aur ek wo jo 51 se 59 ke the. Jo first group tha, that was merged under both the schemes. Why? Because for Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, what is the age limit? 18 to 50. And for Suraksha Bima Yojana, what is the age limit? It is 18 to 70. So the first group, which is of 18 years to 50 years, and this group is merged under both the schemes, kyunki dono ki age limit ye cover kar raha hai. And the second group was merged under the PMSBY, because SBY ki jo age limit hai, wo hai 18 to 70. और जो सेकंड ग्रुप था वो किसका था? 51 से 59 इयर्स ऑफ एज वालों का. ऑलराइट, अब जो फर्स्ट ग्रुप था ऑफ 18 टू 50 इयर्स, क्योंकि वो दोनों के अंदर मर्ज हुआ है, तो उसका जो प्रीमियम होगा वो कितना हो जाएगा? 342. व्हाई? बिकॉज 330 फ्रॉम प्रधानमंत्री जीवन ज्योति बीमा योजना एंड 12 फ्रॉम सुरक्षा बीमा योजना. सो 330 प्लस 12 मिलकर कितने हो जाएंगे? 342. तो जो फर्स्ट ग्रुप के लोग होंगे, मतलब जो कन्वर्ज्ड पीएमजेजेबीवाई और पीएमएसबीवाई वाले होंगे, उनका प्रीमियम हो जाएगा 342. ऑलराइट, नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस इन शॉर्ट अबाउट आम आदमी बीमा योजना आल्सो. सो दिस वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2013 एंड इट प्रोवाइड्स डेथ एंड डिसेबिलिटी कवर टू पर्संस ऑफ एज ग्रुप 18 इयर्स टू 59 इयर्स एंड द एप्लीकेशन शुड बी फ्रॉम अ बीपीएल फैमिली और मार्जिनली अबव द पॉवर्टी लाइन. द एनुअल प्रीमियम अंडर दिस स्कीम वॉज ₹200 एंड इट प्रोवाइडेड ₹30,000 on natural death, ₹75,000 on death or total permanent disability due to accident, ₹37,500 for permanent partial permanent disability due to accident. And there was also a scholarship under this Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana, which provides an add-on benefit wherein scholarship of ₹100 per month per child is paid on half yearly basis to a maximum of 2 children per member studying in 9 to 12 standard. So this was about Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana, but now it has been converged under Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana and Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana in two groups. First group is of 18 to 50 years and second group is of 51 to 59. In first group, jo first group hai wo merge ho gaya hai dono ke andar, and jo second group hai wo merge ho gaya hai keval Suraksha Bima Yojana ke andar. All right. Now what was the question guys? Question is, since 2017 these schemes are called as Converged PMJJY and PMSBY because Aam Aadmi Bima Yojana has been converged under these schemes. All right. Now, next question is, on the occasion of the International Women's Day, that is on 8th March 2020, Ministry of Finance released data on the women beneficiaries under the various schemes. According to this, as on 31st January 2020, what is the percentage of women enrollment under PMJJBY and PMSBY? Okay, so let us discuss about this data. So under PMJJBY, 40.70% enrollments are of women members and 58.21% of claim beneficiaries are women as on 31st January 2020. And approximately 1.9 crore females have enrolled out of a total of 4.7 crore approx. And under Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, 41.50% enrollments are of women members and 61.29% of claim beneficiaries are of women and 6.2 crore approximately females have enrolled out of a total of approximately 15 crore enrollments. So what was the question, guys? What was the question? The question was, what is the percentage of women enrollment under PMJJY and PMSBY? And the options are over 45, between 25 to 35, over 50, less than 40, over 40. So guys, E, over 40% is the correct answer, because the enrollment was 40.70% under PMJJBY and 41.50% under PMSBY. Now question number 4 is about Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana, and we have to identify the correct statement out of these 5. Okay, so first statement is, it is available to people in the age group of 18 to 50 years. Yes, this is absolutely correct. It is an insurance cum mediclaim scheme. No, it is not a mediclaim scheme. Premium is given on annual basis. Yes, rupees 330 annually. Quarterly premium of rupees 330. No, annual premium of rupees 330 is given. And it has not any investment component. Iske paas koi bhi investment component nahi hai. So, ye bhi bilkul sahi hai. So, therefore, guys, correct option ki agar hum baat karein, to pehla correct hai. Third correct hai aur fifth correct hai. So therefore C, 1, 3 and 5 is the correct option to this question. Okay. Now next question is about Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, and we have to again find, we have to find the incorrect statements now. Okay. So it provides 1 lakh for any type of disability. No. Premium of rupees 12 per annum has been taken from the applicant. Yes, this is correct. It has mediclaim component also. No, it is not a mediclaim scheme. And hospitalization expenses are also given. No. And age limit is 18 to 70 years. Yes, this is correct. So guys, in we have to identify the incorrect statements, which mean statement number 1, statement number 3 and statement number 4 are incorrect. So therefore guys, B, 1, 3 and 4 is the correct answer to this question. Okay. So guys, that's it for today's session. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. Milte hain next session mein. Goodbye, take care, God bless, and keep watching PIB 24/7.